This is to ensure that contrast is consistent on both sides of your TV. Now look for the three dots at the sides and in the middle. We're highlighting them here. These dots are your end markers and the dead center marker. Notice how the end markers don't go all the way to the end. Remember how we talked before about below black and above white? Well, the sections of the ramp pattern outside of these end marker dots are below black and above white. You now have quite a simple task. Using your TV remote, turn the contrast setting up to 100% or the maximum your TV allows. You'll probably find it appears quite intense. Now check out the above white and below black areas beyond the end markers. You need to lower the contrast one step at a time until you have a clear and distinct step from one shade of grey to the next, starting right from the above white marker to the below black marker. The areas beyond those dots to the left and right are above video white and below video black. Ideally, you should also see equal steps through all the shades from above white, through dark grey, through black. If you can't get all of the steps in the darkest range to display, which is quite possible depending on the type of your television, this is okay. In this case, make sure that you can see the steps between white and above white. Just do your best here to maximise the total number of steps displayed in the grey scale. Don't forget to pause the pattern before making your adjustments. Okay, we're now going to optimise the colour settings on your TV. Before we start, use your TV remote to find the colour setting and also hue and tint if they're available. Refer to your TV manual if you need help. You now need to use the colour filter card included in the case with the guide. On the card are three filters, one red, one green, and a blue one like this. These filters are specifically designed to block out all colours apart from the one you look through. A bit like this. Blue. Red. Green. So how do we use it? This colour bar pattern is used to adjust both the colour and the tint of your display. You will need to adjust the colour setting while looking through the blue filter. What you are trying to see is this exact pattern. Six black blocks with no interconnecting lines on a plain blue background. Start with the colour down near the bottom and work upwards until you match it. Blue is by far the most important of the three colours to get right. It has the most impact of all the colours displayed by your TV. Now, red and green are a little more complex and will depend on your TV. If your TV has options to adjust the tint or hue, then we're good to go. Otherwise, you may well want to ignore the red and green filters. For red, you're trying to make it look like this. You need to adjust the tint or hue settings to get the pattern to look like the image shown here. Don't worry if you can't get it exactly right. And green, well, it should look like this. The green setting is particularly difficult to achieve unless you have a professional monitor. I suggest you focus on the blue and have a go at the red if your TV lets you. The ideal output is printed in the user guide. Refer to that and remember what you need to do to adjust the colour pattern. Remember to pause when the pattern appears. we're going to use a new pattern called overscan. The intention here is to try to remove the overscan on your picture and make the image as sharp as possible. Firstly, I need to explain what overscan is. On an old style TV, your picture had to be projected bigger than the visible screen. On these old sets, the manufacturer picked the screen size and covered the edges with a border. This meant the edge of the picture was hidden, resulting in what we refer to as overscanning. These days, we have these amazing flat panel screens with perfect geometry and a picture that goes right to the very edge. But believe it or not, manufacturers are still overscanning the picture. Luckily, most new TVs have a way to fix it really easily. On this pattern, you can see a measure of screen size. If your TV is not overscanning, the measure will go right down to 0%. But if there is overscan, it'll be stopping around 5% or 10% all of the way around. That means you could very well be missing out on 5 to 10% of the picture you should be seeing. What's worse, on a modern flat screen HD TV, a HD picture has been designed to be displayed exactly the same shape and size as your TV screen. So any overscanning will stretch the picture, making it slightly distorted. If you can't see the very edges of the screen, look for options in your TV menu such as overscan, just scan, screen fit, full pixel or similar, and adjust or select them appropriately. They are often under aspect ratio settings, but some TVs bury the option in other menus such as system settings, so you might have to have a good browse around the menu. Refer to your TV's manual if you're not sure. When you find this setting, you should see the overscan pattern shrink a little bit and reveal the very edges. Pause the pattern while you have a look at this before we get started on adjusting the sharpness.
Perfect.
Hopefully you have now found the option and retrieved any missing bits of picture. We are going to use the overscan pattern again, this time to set the sharpness of the picture. This might also be called softness on some televisions. Looking at the overscan picture and starting with the sharpness setting at its lowest, very slowly bring it higher until fuzzy edges appear around the white and black lines and text. Then bring it slowly back until you reach the setting that looks just right to your eyes with no fuzziness. Remember to pause again. Great, you have now completed all the stages of the test patterns and nearly finished your TV's optimization. We just need to tidy up some loose ends, and then you're done. Firstly, when you go back to the menu in a moment, you'll find some demonstration videos under the heading Check the Results. Take a look at these to see how your newly optimized TV has improved the picture. Remember at the start we said that colours would be more natural and you'd see more detail? Well, you should be seeing that now. You might think that the picture is a little dim at first, but don't forget, as we explained earlier, you're comparing this picture against the level where the contrast and brightness were set to grab the attention in a store. You'll now be rewarded by a more naturalistic picture in finer detail. Oh, and save on energy too. Don't forget, you've only set up the input your TV is connected to watch this video. So if, for example, you're watching this on a Blu-ray player connected to the HDMI 2 input, then it's possible only HDMI 2 has been set up and not the other inputs to your cable or satellite devices or games console. Your TV might have an option to automatically copy settings across to all other inputs. If not, you can do it manually. We've left some space in the user guide for you to jot down your optimized setting numbers. We suggest you do that for future reference. Don't be afraid to run through the process again. Now you're more experienced, you might find you get even better results. Remember, if you need any help at any time, you can visit our website for support. The address is displayed at the bottom of the screen. Thank you for optimizing your TV with KnowHow Picture Perfect. We hope you enjoy your TV's perfect picture.